final leg here to recap the World Indoor Tour meeting that just went down yesterday in Dusseldorf, Germany. Some great high quality performances. We're still rolling with the indoor season, even though World Indoor Championships has been canceled. We're going to jump into things though. First off, I think the highlight is that men's pole vault. We had Sam Kendricks going up against Mondo Duplantis. They were both going head to head. Mondo Duplantis still managed to come out the big winner, getting a personal best of 6 meters, clearing it on his second attempt. Not only a personal best, a national record, a meeting record, a world lead for 2020. Huge performance for him. Sam Kendricks was right behind. He managed to jump 5.80 meters, equaling his season's best. But the real big highlight was when Mondo Duplantis took attempts at 6.17 meters, the world record. It would have surpassed the world record of 6.16 set by Renaud Lavillenie back in 2014. He took 3 attempts at it. His closest attempt was his second attempt. He just made it over the bar, nicked it a little bit, and then as he was coming it down, he nicked it with the inside of his elbow. So unfortunately couldn't get it, but he's showing that potential that he has. He's definitely going to be challenging potentially for that world record later on in the season, and we're definitely going to see some great competitions outdoors in the pole vault. Now, moving over to the 60-meter dash, this turned out to be a really great competition. CJ Uja from Great Britain, he managed to grab the win, running 6.53 seconds, the number 2 time in 2020 indoors. Also, personal best for him, so again, very, very great quality and great performance for him. He was followed closely behind by Brandon Carnes from the United States. He came away with a best of 6.56 seconds, which makes it number 3 in 2020 indoor 60 meters. So, great performances from both these guys. Now, in the men's 1500 meters, we had a great world-leading performance from Philip Ingebrigtsen competing for Norway, one of the three brothers who's been really making headlines over the past couple years. He managed to run 336.32 seconds, again, 2020 world-leading performance indoors, a personal best for him, definitely showing not only indoors but outdoors he's going to be making an impact. Heading up to the 3,000 meters, we had Selman Borrega from Ethiopia, the 2019 world silver medalist at 5,000 meters from Doha. He managed to grab the win here, running 735.71 seconds, 2020 world-leading performance, followed very closely behind by Getnet Wale from Ethiopia. He was doing really well last year in the steeplechase. He came away with a best of 736.03 seconds. So both these guys really showing their quality, definitely going to be going outdoors and really throwing down some great performances at their respective events. Heading back down, this time to the 60-meter hurdles, we had a really great performance from Yaqub Mohamed Al-Yuba competing for Kuwait. He managed to get a huge personal best of 7.54 seconds. That's a 2020 number 2 in the world this year. This was just coming after he set a personal best in the heats of 7.60 seconds. So really, really high quality. He's definitely going to be showing hopefully more progression. We're going to see what he does not only indoors, but outdoors in those 110 hurdles. On the women's side in that 1500 meters, we had a sighting of Beatrice Chepkowicz, the 3000 meter steeplechase world record holder and world champion from last year. In this 1500 meters, she managed to come away with a huge personal best of 402.09 seconds. Not only a personal best, not only a 2020 world lead, but also moves her to number 16 all time in the 1500 meters. So very high quality. Of course, again, she's a world record holder at the steeplechase, so a result like this is probably definitely expected from her. So great performance for Chepkowicz. Now, the women's 60 meter hurdles turned out to be a great race between a couple ladies, but Christina Clemens from the United States, she managed to come away with the win, running a season's best of 7.91 seconds. Again, a season's best for her. That's actually number 5 in the world for 2020. She's been progressing very, very well. Starting all the way back in the season, she's already competed a couple times, including 2 days ago when she competed in Paris and also ran 7.91. So great consistency. Hopefully it's going to translate to the 100 meter hurdles outdoors. Here though, she was followed very closely by Cindy Rolliter from Germany running 7.94 seconds and Tobia Musan from Nigeria running 7.96 seconds. So great performances in that women's 60 meter hurdles. Finally, ending things off in that women's triple jump, we had Neely Eckhar from Germany. She managed to grab that triple jump win in a best of 14.17 meters. Not only a personal best, but also a world-leading performance for 2020. So really high quality for her. Hopefully it's going to translate to that outdoor season where we might see her progress even more. All right, so those are just a couple highlights from the Dusseldorf meet in Germany. Of course, there's tons of other results that went down. I'm going to leave a couple results down and leave a couple videos there as well. So make sure you guys check those out. Go in the comments below. Let me know what your favorite performance from this meet in Dusseldorf is. Let me know what you're looking forward to. We have a really big weekend coming up, not only with NCAAs, we also have the World Indoor Tour in Turin and also the Millrose Games, which has some high quality performances. So keep tuning in for that. Make sure you guys like the video. Make sure you guys subscribe to the channel, and we'll be back again next video. Thanks.